So here's a tour of KHO. Here's a dog. He's very lucky. Let's follow the dog into the operations room. So yeah, operations room, lots of wonderful computers showing what all the instruments are doing.
We have
them on a TV.
And over here we have dining area.
Consists of this table and kitchen. Yes, we have a wonderful bedroom with bunk beds and a wardrobe and more wheelie chairs. That's a good thing to know, we know. Here we have an airlock because apparently there are ventilation systems for each half of the building. So you need to close both of these doors on your way through. Although you don't need them both closed at the same time, but it's fun to do that and pretend it's actually an airlock. All of these rooms are all the same. There's a little control room and then the instrument through another door, which is very much blacked out, so you don't mess up all your data. Air glow imager, that's one of ours. There's one of ours, yeah. Yeah, and that gives you funky cool pictures of what the atmosphere is doing, essentially. Yeah, this is a room where you can't shut the door because there are too many damn computers in here. So if you leave the door closed, the room will just overheat and catch fire. Which was tremendously well thought out, clearly. And makes the place look quite messy when all the other doors are closed. Apart from, you know, those three and that one. But most of the time, all the other doors are closed, except for, you know, this one. Ooh, all strong imaging. That would probably be one of ours. Just takes a big picture of the whole sky and you can see exactly what it's doing. And it's very good fun because it allows you to see whether or not there's aurora without going outside. Which is excellent because you can stay warm for much longer. That's Professor Lorenzen, who's in charge of everything we're doing. Well, here we have some more all-screen imager things that show what's happening from above, another all-screen imager thing, and what the wind is doing, and where the aurora is. And that is all. Thank you very much.
Almost a regular light bulb down there, and you can illuminate like a football stadium up here. So what we do here then, we have 16 of these producing this power we need for the radar. And you can see, if you go into one of these again, you can see that out of each of the two, the coax from both those two klystrons go up and into that waveguide, the coax from that two goes into that waveguide, and they combine. And you start adding and you're adding and you're adding and you're combining then the signal from all the 16 klystrons and you throw them out either to the 42 meter antenna or to the 32 meter antenna. You never spread the power between the antennas, but sometimes you throw every second pulse out because you want full power when you have power. When we are creating radio waves with these transmitters and we want to transmit them and we want to get them out from the building to the antenna. But what they do actually is that when the waves, this is the wavelength of the radar, which is approximately this. And the waves travel through the waveguide, up in the antenna. We'll be right back.
Told!